The Scottoiler eSystem oils your chain automatically as you ride. Unlike the V-System, the eSystem electronically pumps oil to the chain, so there is no need to tap into the bike's vacuum. The eSystem simply connects straight onto the battery. The other difference being that the flow rate is controlled on the handlebar mounted display unit, rather than on the reservoir itself. The first step is to attach the display unit to your handlebars. This is done by connecting the unit to the bracket using the two self-tapping screws provided. Try to avoid using longer screws as you may compromise waterproofing by doing so. Position the bracket where you choose on the bars and secure tightly as shown. The next step is fitting the dispenser assembly. Some models of bike will require an adapter for this, which you can receive free of charge from Scottoiler. There are three ways to fit the dispenser, either on the bobbin mount, the spindle mount, or on the sprocket guard. On this particular bike, the CBF 1000, we will attach the dispenser to the spindle mount. Firstly, attach the dispenser plate to the spindle and reattach the nut as shown, making sure it is secured tightly. Then, using your thumb, gently push the plate so that the dispenser sits against the sprocket face, avoiding the teeth, windows and nuts when spinning, with the slash cut on the dispenser nib facing outwards to prevent any blockages. The next stage is to fit the reservoir onto the bike. As with the V-System, this can either be positioned on the frame or under the seat. We are fitting the RMV on this CBF 1000 onto the frame and behind the fairing. Find a space where the reservoir can sit at an angle. Either screw or cable tie the reservoir cage to a flat surface or frame tube and always have the filler plug accessible. Next, route the tubing from the dispenser up to the REP. Please note, the check valve needs to be installed after the system is primed. See our installation guide or our filling and priming video for this. Now, feed the battery cables from the display unit to the bike's battery and also connect to the REP. Be careful to avoid hot engine and exhaust components when routing the wiring and be sure to use the supplied cable ties to attach the wires where necessary.